In our group discussion, we sort of talk about supramundane and mundane truth. So in our worldly thinking, we tend to use mundane truth. So there needs to be a concept of I. Whereas when we practice, if we get more and more, we get deeper into the meditation, then we will realize supramundane truth that is not self. So that is what our group thinks. How we can reconcile this apparent contradiction.
Okay, thank you so much. Anyone has any comments about that? Okay, then let me comment. I noticed that you used the word the mundane and super mundane in a way which is quite, not very conventional. Yeah, because in our conventional Theravada usage of the word mundane and super mundane, it means Lokiya and Lokuttara. Yeah, supramundane refers to the path and fruitions. You know, when one has attained something, then we call that supramundane. Right. So I guess what our brother here is trying to say is that he's talking about worldly conventions and ultimate reality. Yeah. The word that is used in among our Abhidhamic circle is paramatta, yeah, Lokiya Panyati and paramatta Dhamma. All right. Okay, that's good. You will see that I am breathing in short, I am breathing in long, I am walking, I am standing, and so forth occurs so very often in the Satipatthana Sutta. Yeah. There are two reasons for doing that. Now, one is the word I is put in because of the requirement of English grammar. You know, in Pali, there's no I. There's no I. When you can know by the end of the verb. For example, you say gacchami. Buddhang saranang gacchami. Gacchami means I go. Right? And gacchama means we go. Gacchati means he or she goes. Gacchanti means they go. Gacchasi means you go. Gacchata means you all go. So without having to put any pronouns in the front, by looking at the verb, you really know, right? So actually here, there's no I mentioned in the sutta itself. It's just Pali idiom, and because of English grammatical requirements, we have to put the I there. Secondly, all these labelings that you find in direct speech throughout the Satipatthana Sutta and also in many parts of the canonical literature gives a good excuse or a good reason for the Mahasi tradition to make use of labels in your practice. Right? If you are familiar with the Mahasi meditation technique, you will know that there's a lot of labeling that is encouraged. Now, when you breathe in, watching it rising and falling, when it rises, you know, you mentally label it as rising. When it falls, falling. When you have thoughts arising, you say thinking, planning, seeing, hearing, touching, lifting, pushing, putting down, right? So there's enough canonical evidence to show that this is not contrary to the Buddha's teaching. Yeah, but this has a limit to it. You know, if you carry this too far, then it really interferes with your clear seeing of reality. You will be actually conceptualizing all the time. You have to go beyond the labeling. The labeling is essential, perhaps for beginners at the beginning, to help them to bring back their mind to the present moment, to activities at the sense doors, instead of getting lost in thoughts about the past or the future. Yeah, but when due to the momentum of your practice, you no longer need labels. You don't actually need to make use of them anymore. Yeah? Drop them and just be aware of what's happening. Please.
Actually, when we were having our discussion on this, we did wonder why the Buddha said, I breathe in long and I breathe in short. So, hearing what you've just said, then perhaps the translation shouldn't have the word I, Because it sets us really, you know, hey, hang on a minute. It reinforces the I concept. Isn't it possible to just say, you know, knowing, breathing in long, knowing, breathing in short? Then you cut out the I completely and don't confuse all the I's in this world.
Maybe.
Just a comment.
Maybe. Okay, maybe the next time when you teach meditation, you tell that to your students. Just with the I. Yes.
In our group, we say that the... you say I breathe in long, yeah, but this I is not me.
Okay. I breathe in long, but the I is not me. So maybe you have to put in an additional label. I breathe in long, but that's not me. Okay?